Right, as you can see, we have changed to a different angle. I've tried this one once before, and generally speaking, it was all right. So we just try something a bit different. Hello, Hans, and welcome to a gameplay video, which is probably rather surprising because you can't see any game at the moment. Well, that'll change very, very shortly. This is Retro Bear's Hans, and the top of his arms, doing my best Gernaldinho impersonation, and welcoming you to the latest video in my series on Wii game show games, which really aren't very good. So what we're going to be doing today, if I can, there we go, focus on the hands, is to just go through an absolute piece of rubbish starring no other than human morph Vernon Kay. Playing everyone's favourite family game show with Vernon Kay. Now, there's so many things wrong with that sentence, I really haven't got time to go through all this. Apologies for the glare, because that's where the light is overhead. So I'll just sort of put it about there or something. Anyway, so yes, what we've got here, this is Family Fortunes. Now, just a quick introduction, because the video's not very long, the gameplay isn't very long, so I thought I'd just do a quick introduction before we got going. For those of you who are watching overseas in America or Canada or Australia, certainly in America, Canada anyway, this is a game show which you will know better as Family Fued, which was hosted for many years by a guy called Brian Coombs. This is the UK version, and about the 12th different variety of that over the years. The series first started in the 70s with British comedian Bob Monkhouse hosting, then he dropped out, and but Max Bygraves, who was a singer and entertainer from the 50s and 60s, took over, and then Les Dennis, who was a very sort of low-rent impressionist and comedian, and I use comedian in the old commas, and then somebody else has taken over many, many times since then, and then he's been doing it. I think it stopped a few years ago now, and you don't see much of Vernon Kay on television anymore. Thank goodness for that. For those of you wondering the reference about human morph, again, overseas you won't know what I'm talking about, but most people know morph in the 70s and 80s was a plasticine stop motion character, basically brown with big eyes and spoke absolute gibberish. It's the best description I can give for him, really. And this format as well, I believe, came to the UK possibly, and again, I'm not entirely 100% accurate, I think British legendary entertainer Sir Bruce, the late Sir Bruce Forsyth, wanted to use this format, or was it a different one? I think maybe use this format, or did a swap with Bob Monkhouse, because Bob Monkhouse really wanted to do this, and then Bruce Forsyth ended up with a generation game. That will mean nothing to quite a lot of you, but anyway, a bit of information there. If you want to look it up, go on Wikipedia, that's why it's there. So what we got here, very, very simple, Wii game, which is disc upside down, there you go, Family Fortunes. There's an instruction booklet. Why there's an instruction booklet with it, I do not know. That's the back of it. I don't know why I'm showing that, because you're going to see the game in a second anyway. Now, for the purpose of this video, I'm playing a one-player game. Also, for the purpose of the video, I've got no friends to play it with, so that's the other reason for doing it. There's a few different rounds. There's also an end game as well. I'll try and explain as we go along, but if you know the format of the show, it's very, very simple. You have a number of rounds where you ask a series, a general public, ask a series of 100 questions, 100 members of the general public, well, I'll start this again shortly. Right, start again. The 100 members of the general public were asked a question, and basically the idea is to find out what those answers are. Judging by the responses from the people, the bigger the response to a certain answer, the higher the score. So, for example, if you you know, name something that is hot and you would say fire, that is likely to be the top answer, the most obvious one. If you said something hot is like chili sauce, that may not be such a good answer. And the idea is to find the top answer and the rest of the answers to make up the 100. Every wrong answer you get a great big cross and that well-known Family Fortune sound, which goes and that's it, and you get 3 of those and you're out the game. If you're playing 2-player on this, there's a different format where the other team gets an opportunity to come in and get 1 question right and nick all the points. you get three rounds of this and you get like a couple of rounds of sort of double money or big money, as Max Polygraves used to say in a much more cockney voice than that. And then the end game is very, very simple. Again, what you are pitted, very, very straightforward process. Two members of your team get asked the same five questions. First person answers all the answer the questions with the answers they can do. The second person then goes in and tries to answer the same questions but giving different answers. And the idea is between the two of you, you manage to accumulate 200 points and then you win the star prize. Each time you get a top answer throughout the game, you win a spot prize. Whatever that may be, I have absolutely no idea. As you will see, we go through the game to see what is occurring in the world of Family Fortune. So that is Family Fortune. This is a game which for some reason still holds its value. You can't get it dirt cheap. It's not one of these like 50p games. No. And again, if you're watching overseas, 50p at the moment, the current exchange rate is probably about 4 cents in America, the way our economy is going over here. But this I've seen this game go as high as about £4 in CEX, which is absolutely ludicrous because it's a piece of crap. I've done a few of these and I've got a few more to do, and this is just absolute. Yeah, I'd have to sort of put a disclaimer on the front of the video if I want to give my exact findings for it. So anyway, that is Family Fortunes on the Wii. Yep, that's about as good as it is. So let's get to some gameplay footage, shall we, because that's all reason why you're here. Right, so just repositioning the microphone. So this is it, Family Fortunes on the Wii, and it's a series of awful games. There really are some terrible games that got made for this, and I'm pretty sure this was sort of done by the same people who did all those other games. Talkback Thames was the production company. Mindscape are all over this sort of thing, and that company there, Slam, you'll see that quite a lot in the next few videos, I can guarantee it. So let's long loading time again, no reason for the loading times on this. I'm not sure whether there's a fault with the disc, but it keeps skipping through some of the video footage. Looking at the back of the disc, I don't think there was anything particularly wrong with it. No, in fact, the disc is anything that's as clean as a whistle, so I don't know whether Wii is struggling to cope with sort of like graphics and, yeah, all these funny things that Vernon Kay is doing here. Hours of fun in the graphics studio putting that entrance together. I mean, let's be honest with you, he looks more like Morph than he does on the front cover of that game, doesn't he? Absolutely horrible. And again, all the characters in this game that have been generated just look absolutely terrible. So two options here, one is also Family Fortunes and the other one is My Family Fortunes. I've got no idea what that was. Single game, and then you're given an option of picking four different families. So again, this is absolutely no relevance whatsoever to it. You just need to pick five people. They could have given random people. Of course, you're meant to be part of a family, which is the whole point of the game. So you're going to pick one of these four generic families, so we'll go with that one. So first up is single money, and this is the bottom left is the question, and then on the right you're given a series of answers. And I couldn't understand that. Bus ticket, a type of ticket, bus ticket, I mean that's fairly obvious, isn't it? Isn't it? Couldn't quite understand why that was the case. So name another type of ticket, speeding ticket, and there you can see we mentioned before the top answer. So the top answer means that you win a spot prize, and it's an iPod. Which is great because I don't have one of those, so I'm very pleased with that. But the idea, you've still got to find the rest of the answers on that run. And of course, the thing is, by doing this, you sort of forget what you picked before. Is a plane ticket there? Yes, it is. That's good. So you can see the score is 70. You've got to obviously get 100 to clear the round. And I don't know what it is with these characters, with people with, you know, stupid dead eyes and giant lips and stupid hair. No imagination has gone into this all. I mean, if you saw the Deal Note Deal video, there's a bit of imagination gone into that one. So you've got to try and remember golden ticket, that was from Charlie in the Chocolate Factory. Plane ticket I've already picked.
It's not there.
Train ticket. No. Why is train ticket not on there? What other sort of tickets can you pick up? You'll notice there's a comedy answer. There's Ticket to Ryan, which is the Beatles song. Movie ticket, concert ticket. That's not on there.
That means you've lost. lost control of the game.
So, as I've got three strikeouts, that means at the end of the round. Now, in a two-player game, the other team will come in and need to get the missing answer to take all the points. The one I'm missing was movie ticket. Let's check the score. I'd have never got that in a million years if I carried on doing it. They look like the most ridiculous collection of people you've ever seen in your entire life, don't they? And that's what I think he said. There's a picture there of Vernon Kay, and then sort of like he disappears. So I get a feeling there's probably an issue somewhere with this dish. A job you don't want to do at heights, window cleaning. Well, let's be honest with you. How many more professions are there? Oh, there's quite a few. But I would have thought window cleaning would be the top one. Flying. That's not really a profession, is it? Or a job. Flying. And I have a bad activity for someone who's afraid of heights. Flying, yeah, obviously. Skydiving. Yes, top answer. There we go. So I've won another spot prize. And it's another iPod. Well, I've already got one of those. So I've got two now. I think it's been a bit more exciting than that. And this is the game. This is it. It doesn't get any more exciting than this until we get to the double money ring. Bungee jumping. That's on there. By all means, play along at home. Shout out the answers. Because no one's listening. Bridge building, height base jumping. Well, that. I mean, I'm not a fan of heights myself, but I mean, base jumping would scare the crap out of me. Let's be honest with you. Jump off here? No, thank you very much. Bridge building, yes. And why is that not in there either? So, what are the three answers I was missing? Okay. Rock climbing, mountaineering, and hang gliding. Well, you can't argue with any of those, could you, really? So, I mean, oh dear. So, the third single money round. Name something a woman might put in her hair. Hairpin? Oh, dye. No. 100 people were asked the following. That's probably not the most correct answer. There are better ones up there I could pick first. Rollers, there we go, 7. That's a bit more in the right area. 100 people were asked the following question. Of course, if you're Cameron Diaz, there will be a different answer up there. It's not flowers there. In here. Ribbon. We asked 100. No. Mind you, when was the last time I saw somebody with a ribbon in their hair? Probably at primary school, to be honest with you. We'll see if it's there. Comb. You wouldn't put that in your hair, you'd run it through your hair. Come on, Meredith, what's the answer? It's got to be brush. We'll see if it's there. I've already picked comb. Oh, you that idiot. And of course, that doesn't help as well, because you've got to try and remember what answer you had in the first place. Let's check the score. I hadn't even registered near. At this point, I'm sort of using hairspray, hairpin. Who puts hairpins in their hair? When was this survey taken? 1964? Now it's time. Last time I saw a woman with, a girl with a ribbon in their hair. When last time I saw somebody with a hairpin in their hair? Unless they made a terrible mistake. So the double money round, all this is basically everything is worth double the amount of points. So instead of a maximum score of 100, it's a score of 200. Name something you do whilst having a soak in the bath. When I was in the bath the other day, I nearly fell asleep. I nearly became one of those statistics. Anyway, you just sort of like get so relaxed, you sort of go under. I had to actually practically get out of the bath before I ended up drowning myself. Wash was the obvious answer. Oh, I've won a camp-looking fridge. Freezer. Or is it a fridge? It's hard to tell, but it's a very strange colour. I've never seen a pink fridge before. Drink wine. Now, I know a lot of people like to have a bath and have a glass of wine. More people that would go in there and relax. Or eat. Would you eat in the bath? Listen to the radio isn't in there either. I mean, that's another thing that I always used to do. That. I used to have a bath with the door open, move my stereo to the hallway and listen to it. Sing. When was the last time anybody sang in the bath? I never sang in the bath. Good morning round again. Name something people are afraid of. Bad games featuring Vernon Kay, who's not on there. Ghosts. Yeah. 100 people were asked the following question. driving, water, snakes. Snakes is a good one. We'll see if it's there. It's number four. Only 6 people out of 100 said snakes.
In a survey of 100 people,
spiders must be on there. Got to be spiders. Yeah, we'll spiders. Top answer. Ding, 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 ding. So, what have I won now? That's a top. I've won a television which only seems to be displaying 4:3 format. Oh, it's a bit, you know, no 4K telly. Fear of flying. That's a fairly reasonable one. I think it's slightly more accurate than a fear of driving. Fear of the dark. Yes! Yes! With as much fake enthusiasm as I can muster, a full house. And now we're into the final round. So select person to play round one. So we'll choose Miranda. And this is the big money round, so he'll try and explain here. She's going to ask 5 questions. I have to give the best answer for each 5, and then they compare it with what somebody else would have supposedly have done, but they're going to have to make something up just for the purpose of this game. So, name something slippery, ice. Name something other than alcohol, sold in pubs, wine, and so on and so on. You would burn wood around films and DVDs. I certainly alphabetized mine, and you'd expect so. On the left hand side, you can see that these are their answers that the computer has chosen, on the right hand side are my answers. And the idea is to get that total of 174 up to 200. Something other in alcohol, something sold in pub other than alcohol, wine. Nobody said wine. Name something you'd do around a campfire, burn wood. Well, you wouldn't have a fire without burning the wood, would you? I alphabeticised my films and DVDs, why did nobody else? So, at a bus stop, you'd expect to see a bus, and only 12 people said so, and as a result of that, I ended up with 186, which means I've lost. So, on that note, that is Family Fortunes on the Wii. Thank you very much indeed for watching. If you have enjoyed what you see, please do feel free to like, subscribe, comment, and ring that notification bell for further video. Yes, indeed, this game does suck. Actually, no. I am the Retro Bear. Thank you very much indeed for watching this Family Fortune videos. More videos will come up soon, but here's a bit of advice for you if you do this game in the shop. Thanks very much for watching. Bye for now.